is Vishwat BG. I am working as an assistant professor in Department of Information Science and Engineering, SJVIT, Bangalore. I welcome you all to this lab session on machine learning.
Hello students, I'll be explaining you the sixth lab program, which is your the question is as follows. Assuming a set of documents that need to be classified, use the Neo Bayesian classifier model to perform this task. Built-in Java classes or APIs can be used to write the program. Calculate the accuracy, precision and recall for your data set. Okay, so they have clearly told you to use Neo Bayesian classifier to classify the things. Okay, and we have to calculate the accuracy, precision and recall for your data set. Coming to our program, we are making use of library function pandas. Okay, and then we are reading the data. The data is in the form of data set program 6.csv. Okay, so what does it contain? It contains the messages followed by the label. Okay, here we are clearly taking up a textual data for analyzing the how well your model is classifying the data, whether it is a positive data set, whether it is a negative data set, and all those things. So you can see here we have only two columns, which is the message and the other one is your label. Okay, coming to the messages, we totally have 18 messages and we have 18 labels. Okay, so what we are doing, we are reading that, we are reading those data and we are keeping it in a form of a tabular form with the names given as message and label. And then I am printing the total instances in the data set. How many instances I have, that is how many data I have in a data set. I have around 18 instances in your data set. The number of instances I am printing it up. Then it is message of label number is equals to message.label.map. We are mapping your positive values. The labels, if you can see the data set here, you have a label as POS and NEG. POS is nothing but positive message, and then NEG is nothing but your negative message. So what I'll do, I'll just map them to 1 and 0. Okay, and I'm keeping it in the form of an x-axis and y-axis. Then I'm taking up the first 6 instances of your message. So what does your program do here? It will classify the things. Okay, it will take the textual data and it will classify whether it is a positive data or negative data, and it will accurately tell which particular program is positive and which particular message is negative. Okay, so what we are doing, I am taking the total number of instances, then I am mapping your values of positive and negative to 1 and 0, and then I am assigning a x value and y value. After that, I am giving up only the first 6 instances, that is x5 and y5, which starts from 0 to 6. Okay, and then 0 to 6 messages. That I am zipping it up. What do you mean by a zip? Zipping is nothing but you are appending the values. Okay, for example, if I want to zip it, in the sense I have x value to be the I love the sandwich, that is your x value. The y value is pause. When I just put this two different values into a zip, then what it has to do, it should show it in a same column, in the sense, again it is showing it in a same value of x. Okay, so that is nothing but your zip. Okay, I am separating it with the help of a comma. If I want to tell you what a zip do in technically, then a zip function, it takes iterables, that is aggregates them into a tuple and returns it. It aggregates it, it joins it and then returns the value. It can take either 0 or it can take your numerical values and all those things. Okay, so here I am zipping up the values of message and the label and I am printing those values. After that, I am splitting the data. How do I split it? I split your data into training data and the testing data. As we have discussed earlier, training data and testing data, we are doing it in different ways. We have, in general, we'll generally do it in 80-20, 70-30, 50-50. 80 is your training data, 20 will be your testing data. Okay, that I am putting it in a form of a graph, that is x train, x test, y train, y test. Okay, and then I am displaying how many are training data set and how many are testing data set. In our example, training instances is 13, testing instances would be 5, as we totally have 18. Once I split the data into training and testing data samples, the next would be to convert your textual data into a numerical values. How do I do that? In your machine learning, we have different techniques. In this particular program, I am using a technique called as count vectorizer. So this count vectorizer, it is majorly used in order to use the textual data for predicting modeling. So here what we'll do, we'll remove each and every statement into a words, we'll tokenize it, we'll convert it into a token, and then we'll encode it with an integer. Okay, so here for our example, I can just tell you that as in the earlier steps we have seen that I have 6 instances available. I love the sandwich. I'm just taking up the first instance, that is I love the sandwich. This I love this sandwich, what I'll do, I'll convert it into a token. Generally, what do you mean by a token? A token is nothing but a smaller unit, in whichever it is a smaller unit. Okay, so in our example, that is in our sentence, the token is said to be a smaller word. Rather than saying it as smaller, I would just specify it as word, single word available. Example, the tokens here are I love this sandwich. We have totally 4 tokens, and these tokens, they are separated with the help of a process called as tokenization. Okay, so here this process of converting a sentence into a tokenization or whichever form it is, we call it as feature extraction, which is nothing but your count vectorizer. Okay, there are inbuilt functions available in your Skykit learners, which is again applicable only for your Python language. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll convert this into a token. Once I convert this into a token, which is again your unique word, I'll take a count of those words, how many times those words are repeated. In this 6 instances, if I can take an example of I being a single token or feature, then it would be like feature I has been repeated for around 1, 2, 3. How many times? 3 times I am seeing the word I. In the same way, if I take a word called as love, anywhere is it used? No. So it is single time. Okay, in that way I will do it. So what I will do, I make sure that first I will have a count of your features. So how many features we have in this data set? We totally have 44 instances, 44 features available in your data, that I'll be printing it up. Once I do that, I have to list it. How do I do that? See here, I'm just listing out the features for first 5 training instances, which is again the same thing. I love the sandwich. This is an amazing place. I feel very good about this beer. This is very, this is my best work. What an awesome view. All that, all those messages I am taking into account. For those 5 messages, 5 instances, I totally have 44 features, which are nothing but unique words again. And then for each and every instance, I'll either mark it as 1 or 0. That is, if that word is available in that particular statement, I'll mark it as 1 or else it is 0. Sorry. So here, for example, I'll take an example of this one. This is an amazing place. I'll just take it as this is an amazing place. So in this example, this is available. So I'll mark it as 1. Ease is available. I don't see ease here, as it is 44. Maybe it is hidden somewhere. And then awesome or amazing is also not seen. Okay, I'll take some other example of awesome. Awesome related thing it is. Okay, what an awesome view. Okay, so here awesome is available, so it is 1. Okay, and then an is available, it is 1. View is available, it is 1 again. View, okay, you can see here. So what we'll do, we'll have a count in such a way. If that particular word is present in the statement, then we'll mark it as 1. or else it is 0. How many we have? We totally have 5 rows and 44 columns. 44 columns are nothing but your unique words available. Once I get this vector, this is in the form of a matrix or in the form of a vector, okay? This vector is given as an input for your classifier. Which classifier I am making use of? I am making use of Nebias classifier, which is already inbuilt, okay? And we can directly take a, what do you call that as, inbuilt function from your Python, okay? So, how do I do that? From sklearn.nebias import multinomial nb. So, in your Nebias, we totally have 3 different forms of Nebias available. First one being your multinomial Nebias, second one it is Gaussian Nebias, third one probabilistic Nebias, okay? So what we'll do, we are getting an input as, we are taking an input as multinomial Nebias, okay? We are taking an input as multinomial Nebias. So from this multinomial Nebias, I'll start giving the input. That is clf equals multinomial Nebias dot fit. I need to fit this data. How do I fit it? With the help of fit function, and then I'll give the values. What are the values available? It is xtrain underscore dmt and then ytrain. What is your xtrain here? Xtrain is nothing but your array, that is columns and rows. Xtrain and ytrain. After that, I have to predict the data. How do I predict it? With the help of the function predict. Okay. And then I have to classify those things. That is print classification result of testing samples are given below. How do I classify it? See, that is, this is for testing purpose. These values are taken from your testing data set. How many testing data set we have? We totally have 6 testing data set available. So that I'll start classifying it. So what I'll do, I'll first remove the label in your testing data set and I'll again input all those things, values. Then I'll tell that is a bad locality to stay. Is it a positive value? Yes. I do not like this negative. That is, it is negative. I love this sandwich. It is positive. This is an amazing place. It is positive. Next, we will have good fun tomorrow. It is a positive message. Okay. So, these are the way how we convert or how we use your Nebias classifier for classifying the messages. Whether it is a positive message or whether it is a negative message. So, once we are done with that, it is our, in our question, we have the question like, we have to calculate the accuracy, precision and recall. We do have an inbuilt function available for that again. As we have discussed, what do you mean by accuracy, what do you mean by precision, what do you mean by recall in your class. Okay, so I have to just take the inbuilt function. How do I take it? Print accuracy matrix. Print accuracy of a classifier is matrix.accuracy underscore. I'll give the input as ytest and predicted. In the same way for recall, it is ytest and predicted. In the same way, we have to calculate the confusion matrix, which is again given by ytest and predicted. Those things are being printed here. Okay, this is about your 6th program. Okay, so once we are done with this, we'll in the next session we'll start with the next program, which is your 7th one. Okay, fine. Thank you.